أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم لقد ابتغوا الفتنة من قبل وقلبوا لك الأمور حتى جاء الحق وظهر أمر الله وهم كارهون ومنهم من يقول ائذن لي ولا تفتني ألا في الفتنة سقطوا وإن جهنم لمحيطة بالكافرين إن تصبك حسنة تسؤهم وإن تصبك مصيبة يقولوا قد أخذنا أمرنا من قبل ويتولوا وهم فرحون قل لن يصيبنا إلا ما كتب الله وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون قل هل تربصون بنا إلا إحدى الحسنيين ونحن نتربص بكم أن يصيبكم الله بعذاب من عنده أو بأيدينا فتربصوا إنا معكم متربصون قل أنفقوا طوعا أو كرها لن يتقبل منكم إنكم كنتم قوما فاسقين وما منعهم أن تقبل منهم نفقاتهم إلا أنهم كفروا بالله وبرسوله ولا يأتون الصلاة إلا وهم كسالى ولا ينفقون إلا وهم كارهون
عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين My beloved children, my sons and my daughters, I am here to see you, and it is not you who is here to see me. So this is a very different meeting and a very different visit because I requested this visit simply li wajhi Allah, no other reason. I told the organizers before I came, there is one thing I need to do in Uganda. I want to visit Musa Islamic Center. Finished. So maybe people are surprised why. I'm here to answer that question. Do you want to know why?
Yes.
Okay, sure. I am excited to be here. I was very excited to be here simply and only for the sake of the Quran. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَرْفَعُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ أَقْوَامًا وَيَضَعُ بِهِ آخَرِينَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَرْفَعُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ أَقْوَامًا وَيَضَعُ بِهِ آخَرِينَ Allah raises through the Quran some and drops others. The same Quran. Wallahi. Some time back, I saw a clip of someone reading Quran. They were sisters in niqab. Or they might have been one. I don't even know the name and I'm not really worried about the name. But I heard a good recital. إِنَّمَا يَعْرِفُ ذَا الْفَضْلِ مِنَ النَّاسِ ذَوُوهُ Do you know what that means? إِنَّمَا يَعْرِفُ ذَا الْفَضْلِ مِنَ النَّاسِ ذَوُوهُ In a nutshell, I can explain that in English. It means those with some virtue are only recognized by others with a similar virtue. Sometimes people say, very good recital. They are talking of a voice. They are talking of a tune. Sometimes people say, oh wow, very good this, very good that, but they don't really, really know But when you know, you know. Subhanallah. So when I heard the recital, yes, we might have been able to tweak a little bit here and there. One or two small, very small matters that might have been tweakable. But I recognized a very great effort. And I told myself, Wallahi, one day I will visit these people. This was some years back, some time back. I don't even know how it was founded, who did it, who is Mudir, who is not Mudir, who is the teachers, who are the others, who are the students, how they're operating, what. But the love of the Quran is what drew me here. I know that there is an effort required here. We in Zimbabwe are running many institutions just like this one. We have boys and girls just like you have. And we take them from the age of 3 years as orphans. And we push them all the way through to university. And they either join whatever they want to join. Today I am hearing something, and my president is sitting next to me, Sheikh Omar Piri. He is the president of Majlis Ulama of Zimbabwe. We have traveled here together, and he will bear witness that we also started just like this. Right or wrong, Sheikh? We started just like this, few students. It grew more and more. It went further and further, subhanallah. And today we have 1,000 students and more in 4 different institutions and many more across the country. Walillahi alhamd. Sorry, I'm Zimbabwean, he's Ugandan, he said. Excuse me. So when I heard this recital, then I heard a few more recitations. Then I, subhanAllah, my children got involved. They started to hear, listen, these people, they're working hard. I don't care where you are, but I care for the effort that is made. It needs to be acknowledged. There is an effort, congratulations. May Allah accept it from you. Don't allow anything to deter you. Work very, very hard. There are people who will recognize the effort of Allah. There are other places I have already visited in other parts of the world with similar effort, just because of Quran, just because of the deen of Allah. I am here because I really love you. You have made me cry without me knowing you. Did you hear what I said? You made me cry without me knowing you, Allah. You are my sons and my daughters, Allah. And I really feel that if I was Ugandan, I would be part of this center by the will of Allah. And centers similar to this. There might be other centers which we don't know about. We support all good activity. But what we found out about, it's our duty to assist, to help, morally to support you. The fact that I'm visiting here, I hope it can encourage you at least. وَقُلْ اِعْمَلُوا فَسَيَرَ اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ. I'm very, very proud of the achievement of the boys and girls, and I'm sorry that we don't have so much time to listen to everyone, but we have already heard you before, already on social media and on YouTube. So well done, congratulations. May Allah bless those who established the center. May Allah bless those who are running it. May Allah bless those who put an effort in it. May Allah bless all those who send their children here. May Allah bless the children and keep them steadfast. Remember one thing. Your center is like a train going to the destination that you want. If you leave the train, the journey will continue with other people. You are the one who lost. You understand? Some people jump off the train. Am I right? They jump off the train. Does the train stop? No, it continues. More and more people will jump on the same train. They will get to the destination. Those who left the train, they are the ones who lost. They stopped their journey. I know people who leave the train sometimes, and thereafter they regret later, I should have stayed, I should have done more work, I should have worked hard. And the final message I have for you is the Quran is the word of Allah. And Allah is Rabbul Alameen. Don't underestimate the barakah of the Quran. When I was young, I was just like you. Sheikh Omar Piri is older than me. He's the president of my organization, and I am the vice president, subhanallah. So he's actually my senior. When I was young, my father used to teach me, and I used to learn at home. We had a center also. I used to study there. They were very, very strict. In my time, corporal punishment was very normal. You know what is corporal punishment? Everyone said yes, so loud. I'm frightened. At my time, it was very normal to beat. I used to get beaten. Am I right, Sheikh? Yes. I remember running around being from the back. I remember. My mother told me one thing. She said, you know, my son, the Quran, if you give it importance, automatically the world will give you importance. When I say, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ, what do you think it means? Can someone tell me? إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ, what does it mean? Yes.
That we are the one who revealed the Quran and we are the one who is to protect it.
We are the one who revealed the Quran and we are the one who is to protect it. Correct. So that means Allah will protect the Quran, right? If you have made an effort to put the Quran into your heart, Allah needs to protect you and your heart. Did you hear what I said? When a man has a diamond in his hand, he needs police walking around him. Why? Because they need to protect the diamond, not him. You understand? You have something more than a diamond. Allah will look after you. Allah will protect you. One of the scholars, Abu Hassan al-Nadawi, you might have heard his name, rahmatullahi alayh. He visited the center. So someone told him, هذا يحفظ القرآن. هذا يحفظ القرآن. You know what he said? بَلِ الْقُرْآنُ يَحْفَظُهُ. Allahu Akbar. You understand? They told him, هذا يحفظ القرآن. He said, بَلِ الْقُرْآنُ يَحْفَظُهُ. Subhanallah. They put the Quran in their hearts, so the Quran is looking after them. So be careful. Keep working hard. Be humble. When you have Quran, don't be arrogant. Don't be haughty. Talk to people nicely, with respect. Shaitan will try to come to snatch away the akhlaq and qiyam of the Quran from you. You need to move as though you are moving Quran. Aisha radiallahu anha was asked about khuluqun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his character. She said, kana khuluquhu al-Quran. His akhlaq, his character was the Quran. So I want to just encourage you in this, and I really would like to thank my hosts who are the Islamic Supreme Council of Uganda to facilitate this with Musa Islamic Center, so that we came here today in order to look and to share and to be able to see you. This, like I said, I wanted to meet you. It's not like you wanted to meet me. I wanted to meet you. It was easy to say, you know what, call them here, bring, no. We want to come here, we want to see you, congratulate you, encourage you, and tell you keep going. The world, subhanallah, will benefit from the effort. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant acceptance to all of you. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammadin. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.